morning. As you have already been informed, I come from the Directorate General for European Programs Coordination and Development. I'm the director of the Directorate for Research, Innovation, and Lifelong Learning. And as such, we are responsible for research and innovation policy in Cyprus. So we have the responsibility to promote a national policy on open access as well. The policy I will present to you is a draft policy, and it's the first time we present this policy document in public. This paper has been elaborated under the coordination of our Director General with in cooperation with a working group for this purpose, and also with the precious assistance of the National Documentation Center in Greece. Once finalized, this policy paper will be put in formal public consultation by our directorate. And when we reach the final document with the comments of everybody involved, we will have to submit it to the Council of Ministers for final approval. And we expect to finalize all these steps, hopefully by the end of the year. The structure of our policy papers, as you see, there is, we have an introduction. We briefly refer to the current European framework for open access. We have a number of definitions, the aim and the benefits of the policy, the provisions for implementation as we see them in Cyprus, some implementing tools, and we also envisage some support and monitoring mechanism. Many of the definitions and notions I will refer to have already been mentioned by the previous speakers, but I will explain to you how we see them in our policy paper more specifically. As I already said, the cooperation with the National Documentation Center of Greece through the program PASTER for open access was very useful in order to initiate and take forward this process. We will try to have a policy paper that is aligned with the best practices of Horizon 2020 and also based on other documents like the UNESCO and the Med Open Line Net guidelines, the record recommendations, open air practices, support actions. We will build on what already is in place. As already mentioned, the European Commission supports open access as the established way of diffusion of publicly funded research in the European Union. And in this respect, open circulation of knowledge is one of the six priorities of the European research area. The European Commission has also issued a Commission recommendation on the 17th of July 2012 on access and preservation of scientific information, and member states have to report on progress in relation to this recommendation every 2 years. As Cyprus, we already submitted our first progress report in March 2014, and for sure in the next progress report we will have something more to say. As already mentioned by the previous speakers, providing open access is mandatory for all publications, peer review publications resulting from projects funded by Horizon 2020. And I think this obligation in Horizon 2020 is a very valuable tool in order to raise awareness and assist compliance with open access in member states. Now, we have a number of definitions in our policy paper. I will not refer to all of them, just to the main ones. As open access, we define the free, direct, constant, and free of fees and most of the copyright restrictions, online access to digital academic and scientific content, readers can use freely the available material for research, educational, and other purposes. And our policy focus on two models of open access, mainly the green route, through which publication in a scientific journal with parallel filing of the final quality assured version in an open access repository with the article being accessible by uninterested persons is provided, potentially after an embargo period if required. And we didn't want at this phase to specify this embargo period and put a specific limit on this. And the gold route, by which publication in an open access journal through which the final quality assured version is immediately available free of charge. The relevant cost is covered through author publication charges per article. The green route is preferable because it doesn't cost much to the public authorities and researchers. The gold route is a very expensive way of promoting open access. Okay, the aim of the open access policy and its benefits are evident. By aligning with the EU policies and existing best practices, we would like as country to participate in a meaningful way in the research and academic ecosystem under development, whereby access to research should be direct and open. And we do recognize that knowledge is a public good, generating social and economic benefits at national, European, and international level. The objective of the open access policy and its benefits, I will say in short, that is the collection, preservation, and dissemination of the publicly funded research. It offers the possibility of indexing and tracking scientific work by international research engines on the internet. It's the provision of data and indicators on research development. It facilitates the internal and external evaluation of institutions and the dissemination of their scientific production. It offers great possibilities of recognition and utilization of and reuse of scientific works. And it's a great way to promote international cooperation. Now, the provisions we have included in our policy paper is that the researchers submit to a repository the necessary metadata, for example, title, abstract, author, title, name of the journal that has accepted the publication, etc. And a digital copy of their publication, final quality assured version. They do this at the same, in parallel. Nevertheless, articles are allowed to be closed until the end of the embargo period imposed by their publishers. But despite this, the abstract of the closed publication must be submitted in a repository in order to enhance awareness. Researchers are encouraged but not obliged to submit to a repository the data sets that support their publications. Researchers are encouraged to make use of Creative Commons licenses that will be explained to us later on in more detail. Researchers are encouraged not to transfer exclusive rights to publishers but only the rights necessary for each publication. And also, we encourage researchers to file in a repository previous work as well. And when we say to a repository, we mean to any repository. In Cyprus, we have three institutional repositories, but also we have Zenodo and many other repositories worldwide. The main implementing tools for the policy is, of course, the existence of electronic infrastructure, the repositories. That this is not a problem because there are maybe 3,000 repositories all over the world and three in Cyprus. Is the creation and implementation of appropriate rules and internal procedures for the implementation of the open access policy by research funding and research organizations and academic institutions? Because our policy paper is a policy framework on the basis of which these organizations will have to develop their own rules. Of course, the training of researchers is very important, especially on repositories, on open access and copyrights, and on how to negotiate with publishers and other and many other issues. And of course, if we want to see the results of our policy, we need a monitoring mechanism. So in line with this, the tools we envisage, in order to support and monitor our policy, we intend to organize seminars, events, and other activities to raise awareness, like the event of today and many others, and also other actions for education and training on issues of open access. And also our Directorate General, in cooperation with other involved stakeholders, intends to establish a special monitoring mechanism to monitor the implementation and the compliance with the policy in Cyprus. And an important step has already been taken for compliance with this policy is the fact that in the framework program to be launched by the Research Promotion Foundation over the period 15 to 20, and the Research Promotion Foundation is the main funding agency in Cyprus, so in this framework program, we have already included that compliance with the open access policy, as I told you, to be finalized by the end of this year, is obligatory. So we think that we are on the right track, and we already took an important step through this funding agency to implement in practice our policy in Cyprus. Thank you.